write down transistor. As an amplifier. Okay, so you can see that there is a relation for input voltage. Okay, so if I again write this down, Vi is VBE plus IBRB, then what is delta Vi? What it should be equal to?
Delta VBE.
How much is delta VBE? First tell me what is VBE. VBE is the barrier potential.
So
yes or no? There you go. Look at this. VBE, you're going from base to emitter. This one is a barrier potential, VBE.
Oh, yes, yes, sir.
Okay. Now, will barrier potential change if you change the input voltage? It remains in a forward bias. It will be more or less close to 0.7 volt only. Okay.
Yeah.
So, VBE will not change if you change input voltage. So, delta VBE will be zero. So delta VI will be equal to delta IB into RB. Okay, so this is your first relation, or let's say third relation. First and two are there. Okay, now similarly, what is delta VO? Delta VO, if you see, whenever we talk about amplification, we keep the output voltage source, if there is any voltage source out at the output side, to be constant. So delta VCC will become zero. Okay, so this will be minus of delta IC RC. So this is equation number four. Okay, so you have voltage amplification, which is represented as capital A with subscript V as delta VO divided by delta VI. All right. So this is equal to minus of delta IC by delta IB into RC by RB. Okay. Now, delta IC by delta IB is beta AC. So this is beta AC times RC by RB. Okay. So you can just vary the resistances RC and RB, and you'll get different values for AV. Fine. So, is this thing clear? Transistor as an amplifier and transistor as a switch. Any doubts?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Those who are watching from YouTube, do you have any doubts? Somebody said something. No doubt, guys, those who are online. All right. So this is it. I mean, with respect to transistor, we will now talk about the most easy part of this chapter, and we are at the fag end of this semiconductors chapter. So
what will we be doing after this chapter today?
That we'll discuss after the chapter. I have few things in mind.
Okay, sir.
Okay. All right. So write down logic gates. Logic gates. See, when you were kids, you have learned numbers 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, right? My daughter has learned up to 30 now. She's four and a half year old. Anyways.
The numbers.
Yes. So you have learned numbers or just counting using numbers. Okay. But the actual usage of number will happen when you learn how to add, how to multiply, how to divide. Okay. Then only you'll be able to do some operations on it. Getting it? Similarly, when you will learn about digital electronics, okay, you will understand that essentially the message has to get transmitted as a sequence of zeros and ones. Okay, so a particular sequence of zero and one could mean a letter A, then another sequence could mean letter B, then a particular sequence could mean color, yellow color, could mean green color, like that. There can be coding done by zero and one. Okay. So one thing is doing encoding a particular thing as a sequence of zero and one. But another more important thing is, you know, doing some sort of operations on it, as in what I mean to say is that how to process the data. Okay. In order to process the data, you need to understand what kind of tools are available to you. I am talking with respect to machine language. I'm not talking about writing a C++ code or something. Okay. So the machine understands just zeros and ones. So the kind of logics that are used to process zeros and ones, they are called logic gates. Okay, so they are very, very simple. All right, so we will directly get into the type of logic gate, and then you'll immediately be able to pick up. Okay, so the first gate is the NOT gate. Write down. The first one is NOT gate, and this is how it is represented. This is the NOT gate. Okay, it has one input and one output, right? So let's say input is A and output is Y. Okay, so when input is zero, what should be the output? One. It is NOT gate. And when input is one, the output should be zero. Fine. So a table between input and output is called truth table. So a truth table is a table between input and output, which lists down all possible inputs and outputs. 0, 1, 1, 0. Clear? This is a truth table for NOT gate. NOT just reverses the input. The second one is OR gate. OR takes the maximum of the two, as in it has two inputs and one output. This is how it is represented. It is Y, let's say input A and B. Okay, so you'll have 0, 0 input, 0 and 1 input, 1 and 1 input, like that. Okay, so can you quickly draw a truth table for this? So this is input, output, this is A, B, and Y. Draw a truth table. Let me know once it is done. Bra faster. Everybody got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 1, 1 will be what?
1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0.
So this is OR gate. All right. Now we will see AND gate. AND gate is represented like this. It is a, you know, flat back A, B, and this is Y. Okay, quickly draw a truth table A, B, and Y. In AND gate, it takes minimum of the two.
Okay,
so when you have 0 0, it will be 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0, and what else?
1 1 1 1 1 1 1.
Okay, all right, so these are the most basic ones. Then there will be a few combinations, as in I can combine, you know, I can combine the AND gate and NOT gate, and I'll call it NAND. Essentially, what I'm doing here, I am putting AND gate like this, and then I am putting a NOT gate like that. Okay, so it's a combination of two gates, and it can be also represented like this. You just put a circle here, it becomes NAND. You can see that is a circle. Okay, quickly draw a truth table for this. A, B, Y. Okay, so NAND will just give reverse of AND, isn't it? So 0 0 should give you 1 1 0 should give you 1 0 1 should give you 1, and 1 1 should give you 0. Is it same as OR?
No, sir.
No. No, sir. The difference is 1 1 0 and 0 0 1. Okay. So this is NAND gate. Now let's talk about NOR gate. NOR is, as you have rightly guessed, I hope, is a combination of NOR
and
yes. NOR gate. So it get represented as this. Hey, where is Samuel, man? Like, totally.
Sir, he is not feeling well today, sir.
You know about everyone, huh?
Sir, no, sir.
No, he did not come, I think, for last couple of classes as well. Anyways, A, B, and this is Y. Have you drawn the truth table?
Yes, sir.
It will be again reverse of OR. 1, 1 will be 0. 0, 1 will be 0. 1, 0 will be 0. And 0, 0 will be 1. Is it like AND gate?
No.
No. 1, 1, 0 and 0, 0, 1. That is the difference. Okay. So these are the few typical ones. Okay. Let me quickly give you a numerical, and then we can proceed further.
So why is NAND called the universal gate?
why NAND is called a universal gate? Probably
it's an NCRT.
I think it's because all the basic gates can be generated from NAND and NOR.
Yeah.
Oh.
All right. So.
So what is the second one again? The second gate.
Tell me.
I didn't see the split up. I thought it was a square or something. So done, sir.
All of you
done, sir.
So which gate it is closest to? As in which gate it is? I mean, if you just have to.
Or.
Is it like or?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let me quickly do this. A, B, and Y. Okay, so like Kevin has messaged, let's see what is 00. 0 and 0, if it goes from there, what will come out here?
1.
1 will come out, and then 1 will go there. What will come out there?
0.
So 0 will be 0. Okay, then 1 will be what? 1 and 1 will go from A and B. Then here it will become 0, and then 0 will go and it will become 1. Okay, similarly 01 will be 1 and 10 will be 1. So it is the OR gate. Okay, all of you understood? Those who are online, please type in any doubts. You guys understood? It's like an OR gate. There are two NOR gates are connected in series. Okay, so let me repeat again. See, 0 and 0 from A and B goes, then this NOR gate will convert 0 and 0 into 1. And this 1 will be fed both sides because it is split into 2. The same 1 is fed. 1 is fed in a NOR gate, so you get 0. Okay, like that you can analyze. Fine, so okay, let me first finish this chapter and then I'll give you one numerical to close this off. So towards the end, there is a definition on integrated circuit, ICs. This is integrated circuits. Fine. So what happens is that when you make a circuit, you have diodes, transistor, resistance, all that are connected, okay? But then if you want to get the same effect and you have lesser space, you want to fabricate entire thing in just a chip, okay? I think you might have seen a chip. So the same effect you can get in a very, very small chip. And when you do that, you call it as integrated circuits, okay? These are electronics chips. So what happens there is that you have a lot of logic gates connected in it, fine? And depending on how many logic gates are connected, there are different names, all right? So there are, let's say, small scale integration, which have logic gates less than 10. Okay, if logic gates, number of logic gates in that circuit is less than 10, it is called small scale integration, SSI. Okay, and if logic gates more than 10 but less than 100, it is called medium scale integration. Fine. If logic gates more than 100 but less than 1000, it's called large scale integration, LSI. And if logic gates is more than 1000, it is called very large scale integration, VLSI. Fine. So this is just naming. Okay, they are not in our syllabus to study further on, but then some one or two mark question can be asked on just the definition of it. Okay, so let me give you a numerical and then we will say goodbye to this chapter. Okay, for this numerical also, I need to show you a figure. Is it? Yes. This one. Example 14.13. You can see on your screen. Try to solve this. The graph should look like this, you know. I'll show you. See, this is how the graph should be looking like. And this line, see, this A is, this horizontal line is zero. It jumps up. So when this goes up, it means one. It remains one from T1 to T3. And then it drops to zero. Then it becomes zero only, and then it goes up. It becomes one. From T5 to T6, it is one. And then again, it drops to zero. Similarly for B, from here to here, it is zero. And then it goes to one. From T2 to T4, it was one. So like this, these are inputs. And then when you draw the output, you'll see that from zero to T1 time period, A is zero and B is zero. So likewise, you can compare what should happen. From T1 to T2, A is 1, but B was 0. Mm. Okay. So like that, you have to draw the graph. And that's what you have to do for.
Sir, learn, sir.
Yes, sir.
Those who are online, are you guys done? Yes, Aditya is not there, right? Mishra.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Yeah, I could not, not able to hear the train sound. Why? What happened to him?
Sir, I didn't tell, sir.
Siddhan, what happened?
Sir, I don't know, sir.
What? Okay, so this is how the plot should be. Is this what you have done? Any doubt?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Proper, correct. Yes, sir. Correct.
Those who are online, is this what you guys have done, or you have any doubts? All right, so chapter is over. Okay, so this is it for semiconductors, and you know, treat as if this is an opportunity for you to score at least 4 to 8 marks in JEE Mains. And it's very hard to find out good numericals on semiconductors. Okay, So you have to literally search for it and look for numericals on semiconductors. But you can start with completing HC Verma, okay? And then look for previous year JEE question. And let me tell you, if you do that, these 4 to 8 marks are not going anywhere. They are in your pocket easily. All right.